versions of TV23's Internet provided by SWKO Wireless Internet. Covering the High Plains with news, weather, and information. From TV23 Studios in Sublette, this is High Plains Today.
Hi, everybody. You know what? It is Tuesday, July 12, 2016. Welcome to High Plains Today right here on TV23. On today's show, Darren Cowan. He is the president of the Grant County Fair Board. Kim Altus and Addie Harold. They're both trouble, but they are 4-H'ers in Grant County. We're going to be talking about their fair that starts this Saturday. In the meantime, let's take a look at some stuff that's happening out there. Well, yesterday afternoon around 5:30 p.m., EMS responded to the Seward County Detention Center in Liberal for an inmate who had collapsed. The officer started CPR. Barry Angel of Liberal was transported to Southwest Medical Center, where he subsequently passed away. Now, the death is believed to be from natural causes. Mr. Angel was a city inmate serving days. The KBI is investigating the incident. And the Dodge City Police Department is investigating a four-vehicle accident that took place around 12:30 a.m. on Saturday. A vehicle was driving northbound when it struck three parked vehicles and then rolled over. The driver of the vehicle then fled the scene. Now, the crash took place in the 900 block of Avenue G in Dodge City. The driver was driving a blue 1992 Toyota truck. No injuries were reported to have taken place in the accident. Now, the name of the possible suspect could not be released due to the incident still being under investigation. The Dodge City Police Department asked that if anyone has any information regarding the hit-and-run accident, to contact Crime Stoppers at 620-227-7867. The Kroger Company has recalled Kroger Deluxe S'mores ice cream sold in its retail stores because the product might contain peanuts not listed on the label. Kroger initiated the recall when a supplier, GrainCraft, indicated a raw ingredient may have become contaminated with low levels of peanut residue. All stores operated by Kroger in 29 states, including Dillon's stores in Kansas, are included in the recall. Kroger has removed this item from store shelves and its initiated customer recall and notification system that alerts customers who may have purchased recalled Class 1 products. And gas prices have dropped another 3 cents for a statewide average, correlating somewhat with the national average price drop of 4 cents. Now, the downward drop continues this week, giving motorists in Kansas a nearly 20% average savings over last year's prices. State average has fallen 25 of the last 27 days since June 14th. The price has dropped nearly 11 cents. Now, while retail gas prices may continue to slide through the month of July, there are a number of factors that could cause prices to rise again. This includes an increase in the global price of crude oil due to disruption in supply, stronger than expected economic indicators, or geopolitical tensions overseas. And the committee to elect Joyce Warshaw will host a Come and Meet Joyce Warshaw event tonight. Joyce Warshaw, the current mayor of Dodge City, is running for the 38th District Senate seat currently held by Garrett Love. Love has chosen not to seek re-election. The event will take place from 5:30 to 7 p.m. tonight at the Rock Island Depot in Liberal. The public is invited to attend, listen to what Joyce has to offer, and, of course, ask questions. And don't forget, we've got our TV23 Yeti Tumbler giveaway going on. There's two ways that you can enter. You know, you can email us at cup@kdgltv.com or mail a postcard to TV23 KDGL, P.O. Box 447, Sublette America 67877. Now, when you do that, though, don't forget to give us your name and your address so that we can send this baby to you. We're going to be drawing for one just like this on Thursday. These are so cool. Don't forget, just register. Stick around. I'll be back with a warm forecast after this.
You're watching High Plains Today on TV23 with host Chris Jewell. TV23's internet service and 4G live streaming provided by United Wireless. Coverage you deserve. Service you expect. United Wireless.
kitchen surfaces, utensils, and hands with soapy water. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Something I feel when I'm right here. Something that tells me that I'm oh, oh, oh.
This is the place.
Everybody here knows it.
This is the place.
Oh, it's home to me and you. Yeah, this is the place.
When some people struggle with their mortgage payments, they become frozen, petrified, not knowing what to do. They do nothing. But the people who do something, the people who take action, are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
Now, the local weather forecast for the High Plains.
And welcome back. Hey, we're looking at the big flag just on the west end of Liberal, overlooking US 50. We're not in Liberal, we're in Sublette. What am I thinking? What is today, Monday? No, it's Tuesday, and I'm already messing up. Oh, well. Let's take a look at our current readings here at the station. 79 degrees, relative humidity pretty high today, 73%. Winds are out of the northeast at 12. Barometric pressure is holding steady. As we look at the current temperatures around the region, you can see everybody already in the 80s except for Hayes, but they're close. They're at 79. Now you can see the dew points awfully close to those temperatures. That's why we're seeing so much humidity. You can see, though, a little drier down in the panhandles. Looking at our current wind speeds out there, everybody pretty much out of the northeasterly direction. Not a lot of wind today. They are going to pick up, though. You get out to Lamar, closer to the mountains, their winds are a little bit on the variable side. Taking a look at our highs and lows as recorded at the Garden City Regional Airport, we did get to 97 yesterday. Far cry from 110 back in 1954. Overnight low yesterday, 73. 51 back in 1999. No new precipitation in the bucket, but we have had over 13 inches year to date. All right, looking at our forecast today. Remember, we were going to get up into the upper 90s. Today, not so much. Our high is going to be 94. Winds are going to be out of the northeast at 13. Gusting up to 23, and then tonight, it's only going to get down to 70. Winds are going to stay out of the east-northeast. They're going to drop down, though, to about 9 miles an hour. Yeah, that's a big number for tomorrow. We're looking at the century mark again. Winds are going to be out of the east-southeast at about 10. Then later on in the day, we do have some precipitation and a front rolling in, so they're going to switch around to the north-northwest. Tomorrow night, 68 for our low, mostly clear. Winds will be out of the northeast at 9. And then you can see on the 7-day, on Thursday, rain starting to roll in. We do have a chance of rain all day Thursday into Friday, Saturday. Going to warm up again, though, over beginning into next week. That's a look at our weather. Be back with the markets and our bunch from Grant County after this.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.
Separate raw meats from other foods by using different cutting boards. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Business with United Wireless. You're doing business with people living and working right here in Southwest Kansas, not someone halfway across the world. We're proud of the fact that every day we serve our friends and neighbors, our healthcare providers and hairdressers, technicians, farmers, and local retailers. You are the people who make Southwest Kansas great, and for all you do, we believe you should be treated with the utmost respect. We are United Wireless, and we are Southwest Kansas proud.
Hi, Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs weekdays at noon right here on TV 23. We talk about news, we talk about sports, we talk about weather, we're even going to talk entertainment. We'll have live guests right here on set with me. So, every day at noon, tune in, High Plains Today. We'll see you then.
Weekdays here on TV 23.
Foods to the right temperature using a food thermometer. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back. Here we are, right here on the set, TV 23 High Plains Today. That's Addie Harold right there. She is a member of the Grant County 4-H system. Over here, we have Darren Cowan. He is the president of the Grant County Fair Board. And then Kim Altus, and she's just been troubled since she got here. But anyway, Kim and Addie are both in 4-H in Grant County. Both have projects. Grant County Fair coming up starting on Saturday. The official Saturday.
Yes.
You have a rodeo on Friday night. Kind of get everybody in the mood, right?
Right.
Okay. But then on Saturday, though, you start off, you're getting right after it, right?
Exactly.
Because you had the parade.
We had the parade on Saturday morning. It leads, it's kind of our kickoff. And then everything. We have a free hot dog feed, I think, at 11 o'clock after that.
Ooh, free food.
It's free food. So, and then the kitty pack tractor pull is, I think, at noon. So we'll...
You got a lot going on.
Yes, we do.
Getting started. Okay, so the parade starts at what, 10 o'clock?
Yes.
Saturday morning?
Yes.
And now, what is the parade route?
The parade route starts at, I think, Hickok School. And it'll go by the care home, so the care home kids can, or people can see it.
Yes.
Then it'll go right down Main Street. So.
Right down Main Street, downtown Ulysses,
downtown
America.
Downtown U-Town, so.
All right, U-Town. I like that. I may use that. Okay. And then you also have a bunch of other stuff going on Saturday, too, right? As far as, is there any 4-H stuff going on Saturday?
No, that pretty much does it. So.
No? There's a dog show.
There's a dog show?
That's on Sunday, isn't it?
That's on Sunday. Sunday. No, it's on Sunday. Now, the horse show is on Sunday, too, though, right?
Yes.
All right, we're going to make Darren get the
book. See, look
out.
At that. Always carry a book with you.
Now, was she right?
No, the dog,
I don't want to prove
it. Yes,
the dog
Saturday.
Show is Saturday at 3 o'clock, see?
All right. Lunch is on him now, isn't it? Okay, now, and I have a question, because on one of the web pages, you guys have, there's a lady, Poppin' Penelope.
Yes.
Is going to be at the Grand County Fair. What is Poppin' Penelope?
She is a balloon artist, and she enjoys her job very much. So she'll go down, and if you want a crown out of balloons, if you want a big, huge, whatever, she'll usually make it for you.
Okay, so she's not your, I can make a little dog out of a long balloon, that's it.
She can make a
she could probably do that, right?
Yes, and she could make actually a dog that looks like a dog, so.
Okay. All right, and then really, though, Tuesday is when things really get started, because that's when all the livestock and stuff starts showing up for the fair, correct?
Exactly.
Okay. Now, Kim, you have livestock in the fair, don't you? No, you have clothing and cooking and photography.
And drawing
and I don't know what else.
I don't know either.
But you'll be there, won't you?
Yeah, I'll be there.
Okay. So, and Addie, what do you have? Oh, you have goats.
Yeah.
You have goats, right? And you have food also, right? And what else?
Photography.
Okay. So you're going to be busy too.
Yeah.
All right. So how long have you been in 4-H?
6 years.
6 years?
9 years.
9 years. You've been doing this a long time.
Yep.
And you were saying you even helped your brother before you were in 4-H, right?
Yeah, I did it.
But we're not counting that.
Well, you can.
No, we're not going to. It's not official. We can't do it. Can we count that?
No.
No, we're not counting it. Okay. So... On Wednesday, that's when most of the majority. Now, I'm going to back up a minute. When you guys start judging your clothing projects?
Today. It was this morning, and then tonight we have our public fashion review.
Okay. All right. And then the food, the cooking stuff, that is on
Monday?
Yeah. Okay. And that's kind of a consultation judging?
Yeah.
Where you sit down with the judges and say, here's what I did. I used this and that. Have you done that before?
Yeah.
How do you like that?
It's okay. Usually they're really nice judges.
Oh, okay. So they don't grill you too hard?
Mm-mm.
Okay, so what kind of questions do they ask you on consultation judging?
Just like how you cooked it, if you would add anything else into it.
Did you steal the recipe out of a magazine?
Yeah, where you got the recipe from.
Okay, all right. I can see you stealing a magazine recipe. Okay, and then on Wednesday... You get started with swine and goat and sheep.
Yes.
Are showed on Wednesday. What else you got? Oh, there's a talent show on Wednesday also,
yes.
Right? Okay. And what's going to be involved in the talent show? Where's that going to be held?
That's going to be in our civic center in the big...
Oh, in the big building.
The big building.
That is air conditioned,
yes.
Right?
Every building's air conditioned except for the show arena.
Could you work on that?
Maybe? It does have a big fan in it.
So. Oh, it has one of those giant fans?
It has a big fan.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I know what you're saying. All right. And then my producers in my ear go, yeah, and we'll just leave it at that.
Yeah.
All right. And then beef is on Thursday.
Yes.
And then there's a free barbecue Thursday night. Okay. You guys had the barbecue before?
Mm-hmm.
How is it?
Good?
Okay. So people want to show up for the... Free is the operative part of that, right?
Yes.
Because you have free hot dogs on Saturday.
Yes.
Free barbecue on Thursday. You have a free rodeo on Friday and Saturday. Free seems to be a good working theme here.
That's kind of what we want to do.
Yeah. So. That's kind of nice. All right. And then on Saturday, also on Friday, now you have a round robin judging?
Yes.
All right. So explain that to me.
That is... The winners of showmanship for beef, swine,
sheep, goats,
dairy. Then you show, you win that, you show each individual animal, so you show in all the categories. Even if you only brought a horse, you will end up showing a steer, a dairy, a pig, a sheep, a goat.
And then you pick a grand winner out of all that?
And then there'll be winners for each age group and then a overall. It's based on points.
Really?
You've been in it before, haven't you, Kim?
Not round robin.
Not round robin.
But cool. I've seen it and helped with it.
Yeah.
You've been in round robin?
Mm-mm. Only the winners get that.
The showmanship winners.
Eddie, I appreciate your honesty. Yeah. I really do. And then poultry and rabbits are also judged.
Yes.
That day. And then also on Friday, you have your big livestock auction.
Big livestock auction, yes.
Okay. And then there's something after that. And you have what, the buyer's dinner?
We have the buyer's dinner, yes.
Okay. What's that consist of?
That is if you buy an animal, the 4-H, they prepare a meal. So it's usually brisket or steak. I can't remember. It's usually really good. So if you buy an animal, you get to go to the buyer's dinner. So
are they cooking the animal you bought?
No.
I'm kidding. I'm kidding. That wouldn't be nice. No, the losers are the barbecue Thursday night, right? No, you have goats, and you wouldn't be happy with that, would you? Okay. All right. Let me ask you two something real quick. Now, you got a lot of stuff going on. Starts Saturday morning.
Yep.
10 o'clock is the biggie because that's when the parade starts, and you run all the way through next Friday, and Saturday's kind of loadout cleanup day, right?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So what made you get into 4-H, Kim?
Me?
Yes.
What made me get into it?
Yeah.
My brother.
Okay. Did he make you? But you were interested in it.
Yeah, because after I would help him with his projects, I really liked it. So I just got into it as soon as I could.
So you're looking forward to the fair?
Yes.
Yes. Good answer. All right.
Good hesitation.
Eddie, how'd you get involved in 4-H?
All my friends were in it, and I just kind of wanted to do it with them.
So how do you like it?
I like it a lot. It's fun.
Okay. Would you recommend it to others?
Yeah.
Have you recommended it to others?
Yeah.
Are you looking forward to the fair? Mm-hmm. All right. What's your favorite part of the fair?
All of it.
All of it.
Good answer.
All right. Carnival. Do you have a carnival?
Yes.
Oh, so carnival. Does that rank right up there or not so much? Mm-hmm. No. Just hanging out with everybody is probably the big thing.
Yeah.
Go out there from morning till night.
Yeah.
Out there all day, every day. What's your favorite part?
Whenever I would show my goat.
Yeah, but you don't have a goat, so you're going to have to pick something new this year.
Well, I don't know. I'll have to wait and see what's my favorite part after the fair.
All right. I'm probably going to be over there on Thursday. So you come into the building and look for my booth late Thursday afternoon, and I want to know what your favorite part of the fair is so far. If not, I'm going to have Darren hunt you down.
No.
All right. All right. You guys, Kim, Addie, good luck this week. Darren, thanks for bringing them over today.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
Have good luck starting on Saturday, Ulysses Parade, 10 o'clock, Grant County Fair, runs all of next week. Get out there and see them. And stick around. I'll be back without this bunch in a minute with more. Thanks.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
I did. Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls. But did you know terry cloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you know that strollers have the right of way on the sidewalk?
Yes.
Yep, I did. Did you guys
Did you know that kids who eat breakfast have higher GPAs?
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Yeah. That's actually what I was going to say.
Did you know babies should never touch silver? It's really bad for them.
I knew that.
Did you guys know that statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat at the right age and size. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
I'm putting that on my blog.
I just put it in mine.
the big guy comes up with that, hitting 342 with 92 RBIs and 36 homers.
Chill raw and prepared foods promptly. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Hey, Giancarlo Stanton wore out Petco Park with a record display of power in the All-Star Home Run Derby last night, peppering every landmark from left field corner to center field. Now, Stanton hit 20 homers in the final round to best defending champion Todd Frazier of the Chicago White Sox. Overall, the Miami Marlins slugger hit a record 61. Yeah, 61 home runs, shattering the single night mark of 41 by Bobby Abreu back in 2005. And that's a bunch. And so much for golf's triumphant return to the Olympics. Any hope of Rio hosting a men's tournament that anyone beyond the hardcore aficionado will give a flip about took a knockout blow yesterday when the last of the big four, Jordan Spieth, delivered his regrets to the powers that run international golf. Now that Spieth has followed the lead of Jason Day, Dustin Johnson, and Rory McIlroy, Rio will be putting on a men's tournament missing the top four ranked players in the world and seven of the leading 15. All right, let's take a last look at the weather before we get out of here. Oop, temperature up to 80 degrees already. Relative humidity hanging tough at 70%. Winds are out of the northeast at 12. Barometric pressure still holding steady. Looking at our 7-day, you know what? We got some heat coming up. Going to be 100 again tomorrow. We do have a chance of rain. Flying in here on Thursday, Friday, and into Saturday morning. Going to start heating up again the beginning of next week. Now, don't forget, register for your free Yeti tumbler. All you got to do is send us an email at cup@kdgltv.com. See you tomorrow.
Keep up to date with the latest information from TV 23 on our Facebook page, KDGL-TV.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million bucks. For free tips to help you save,